Welcome to the RBI podcast.
I'm Katja Fiedler and this is the first podcast in a series on the principles for responsible banking. RBI has signed these principles of the UNEP Finance Initiative in February. I'm now talking to Andreas Sinn-Weber about what exactly these principles are and what they mean for RBI. Andreas Sinn-Weber is head of Group ESG and Sustainability Management, which means she has been involved with responsible banking for quite some time. Dear Ms. Sinn-Weber, thank you very much for explaining today what these principles are all about. To get us started, can you please explain what the principles are?
Yeah, sure. I'm happy to give more information on the topic. So the principles for responsible banking provide, so to say, a framework for a sustainable banking industry, and they were developed via an innovative partnership between banks worldwide and the United Nations Environment Programme Finance Initiative. And so far, about 230 banks have currently joined this movement for change, leading the way towards a future in which the banking community makes the kind of positive contribution to people and the planet that our society definitely expects. Furthermore, these six principles anchor sustainability at a strategic but also at a portfolio and transaction level and in all areas of business. So now let's have a closer look at them. The first principle, alignment, is about ensuring full commitment by the board and relevant units to the Paris Agreement goals, but also to the Sustainable Development Goals and the EU Action Plan, and the integration of sustainable goals into business strategies. With the second principle, named impact and target setting, we have committed ourselves to carry out a comprehensive impact analysis of our portfolio, services and products across the different markets and to define at least two targets with which we think to have the most significant impact. The third principle is called clients and customers. It implies that we support our customers, especially those in industries with significant impact, on their way to a transition towards a more sustainable business model. For example, with advisory or with newly developed products and services. The principle four is about stakeholders. And this topic for sure is not really new to us. It means that we have to further develop our stakeholder engagement strategy and to be in an intense dialogue with our most relevant stakeholders. This includes, for example, a proactively consult, engage and partner with them to achieve the society's goals. And the principle five, governance and culture, closes, so to say, the arc to the first principle alignment. And it should be ensured that those responsible for this strategy have clearly communicated their commitment. And furthermore, it should be made certain that sustainability is integrated into the group's decision-making processes and that we have an effective monitoring in place. And finally, according to the sixth principle, transparency and accountability, we have to do a proper reporting on our progress of implementing the principles and to disclose the impacts, the risks, and the reaching of the targets. So, in short, I would say we have to analyze our current impact on people and the planet, set targets to improve our impact, and finally to define actions to meet them.
Okay, that sounds like a lot of tasks. So, why did RBI join?
So, just as in background information, the approach to act as a responsible banker has been part of RBI's sustainability strategy for many years. And also against the background of being a long-term member of the UNEP Finance Initiative and after extensive preparations, I would say it was more or less a logical next step to sign up to these principles as first Austrian banking group in January. And we see this signing as another, so to say, milestone with regards to our further sustainability development. And I'm really convinced that it will help us in our positioning, for sure, as a responsible banker, but also in improving our reputation, in preparing, for example, climate stress tests, and hopefully in improving our sustainability ratings.
And who is now responsible for the implementation in RBI? And what about the network banks? Do the principles apply there as well?
Yeah, as mentioned before, there was extensive preparatory work necessary before the signing could take place. And so at the beginning of 2020, a responsible banking decision and steering body was implemented, and as well as an operational responsible banking task force. And this holistic approach was important as we have almost cross-divisional topics. And then in last fall, a detailed gap analysis was conducted by all affected divisions in head office in order to get, so to say, the big picture, what we have to expect regarding the related requirements and if they would be manageable in the upcoming years. And the outcome was a list of about 16 fields of action and related tasks. And based on these results, the board then committed to the principles in January, and the signing, which applies for sure to the whole group, was done by our CEO. And in addition, ESG-related KPIs for 2021, in the sense of responsible banking, were anchored in RBI's remuneration policy at the management board level. And this means that the ultimate responsibility for implementation lies with the board. But, of course, all involved managers in the defined work streams and all affected employees in the whole group also share responsibility for ensuring that this important project can succeed.
Okay, I see. There's one more thing I would like to know. How is compliance with the principles ensured, and what would happen if we don't meet all the requirements?
We have committed ourselves that we will implement all required tasks and steps related to the principles within the upcoming 4 years. And we have to report annually on the implementation level. So this means that we will be held to account against them through an annual review of our individual progress. And furthermore, it's important to know that many of the related tasks we need to do anyway from a regulatory point of view within the next 2 to 4 years. So a failure to meet the requirements would in any case be associated with a reputational risk. And against this background, the more important is it that all necessary respective efforts are made. So finally, I'm deeply convinced that it is of a strategic importance to support the transformation towards a more sustainable future, and also to take advantage of the opportunities it presents, and thereby hopefully to make a positive contribution to society. And this is also a main goal of the principles.
Okay, so I wish a lot of success here. And I thank you very much for the interesting interview. I hope our listeners found the topic as exciting as I did and will join us for our next podcast. It will be about the concrete implementation of the principles. Thank you very much for listening.
That was an RBI podcast. Thanks for listening. Until next time.